In this video, I will be talking about the herpes testing. We will talk about the practical aspect of the herpes testing. I will review who should be tested for the herpes, how accurate the herpes testing is, and when the herpes testing can be done. My name is Slava Fuzayloff. I'm the physician at STD Center New York, one of the busiest STD clinics in Midtown Manhattan. So, who should be tested for the herpes? There is a consensus in the medical community that herpes testing is done only if you have symptoms, when you have rash, blisters, sores, and the test in that case is done to rule out other medical condition or to diagnose you with a herpes. In general, STD testing done for three different reasons. Routine testing, when you're just coming to get tested between partners or just to know your status. After exposure testing, when you just do the test after specific exposure to know if you contracted an STD, and when you have symptoms. But herpes is an exception to the rule, and testing is usually advised if you have symptoms only. Obviously, in our practice, when people come and request the herpes test, we usually do the testing, but for the medical reason, the testing is done only if you have symptoms. So why the testing for the herpes is done only if you have symptoms? CDC is advising us not to do the testing, and we obviously agree with CDC. And I'm going to put the link below the video so you can read it from the actual source, from CDC. And few reasons for that, because herpes is a very common condition. 50% of us are positive, assumption is 50%. And if you positive, does not mean that you got it sexually. A lot of people get it from parents, friends, siblings, and both types you can have orally, both types you can have genitally. And it's a safe condition even if you have it, and we usually don't put you on a medication. If you're positive for the herpes, 20% of those blood tests that are positive for the herpes, false positive, it means that other condition can present as a herpes in the blood. So it's a faulty test. And number three reason, CDC is not advising it, because people who know, and multiple studies showed, people who know that they got the herpes usually do not change their behavior. And those are the reason why herpes test is done only if you have symptoms. The next question is, when to get tested for the herpes? How soon the herpes test is accurate? If you don't have any symptoms, only blood test can be done. And the blood test that we do for the herpes is called IgG. We don't do IgM test, it's incorrect test for the herpes, and I'm going to record a separate video why IgM test is not done. And herpes is an exception to the rule, and IgM test is not done for that. When we do the blood test, the soonest we can do the blood test for the herpes is 3 weeks after encounter, and it's going to be 50% accurate. It means that 50% of people can develop antibody that we can't pick up. 6 weeks after exposure, the accuracy goes up to 70%. And 3 months after exposure, the accuracy is around 92%. If you have symptoms, swab test can be done. And swab test cannot be delayed. It should be the timing for the swab test is very important. When you have symptoms, we should do it while you're having blisters and sores. Blisters usually have the highest concentration of the virus, and the swab test is the most accurate. We usually break the sore and collect the fluid, and the concentration of the virus is highest, and it's the most accurate at that time. So, next question is, how accurate is the herpes testing? If we do the herpes swab test, the swab test positive, it's 100% positive, and this is the herpes what you have. But if the test is negative, up to 70% of people have false negative result. And the reason for that, because it was not done at the right time. The right timing for the swab test is when you have a blister. We usually break the blister and collect the fluid from the blister. Or it's a fresh sore with a lot of fluid in it that we collect with a swab and send it to the lab. So if the swab was done on a crusted sores or dry skin, 70% chance it might be false negative. The blood test is very accurate test as well, but the timing is important too. So blood test is an IgG test, and as I said previously, no IgM test is necessary for the herpes. And if the test is positive, 20% of those IgG tests can be false positive. It means that other condition can present as a herpes in the blood. So 20% of the test, positive test, false positive. If the test is negative, 38% of those tests falsely negative. It means that you have a herpes, but it's not showing in the blood, because the test was done too soon. So 38% false negative rate, it means that the test was done too soon. As I said earlier, the herpes test can be done as soon as 3 weeks after exposure, but 50% chance that we're going to pick it up, and 92% chance that we're going to pick it up three months after exposure. So this is going to conclude the herpes testing overview. Now I'm gonna ask you, if the video was helpful, and if it was helpful, please click the like button. Leave your comments so we can see your questions and answer your questions. And please support our channel by subscribing, and we're gonna record more videos very soon. Thank you.